You're listening to the Davey Mac Sports Program on the Riotcast Network, riotcast.com.
It's the Davey Mac Sports Program.
Behind the back, it gets through Buckner. Here comes Knight, and the Mets win it.
The band is out on the field. He's going to go in the end zone. He's going to go in the end zone. The Bears have won. The Bears have won. Oh, my God.
It's the Davey Mac Sports Program on Riotcast.com. And here's your host, Dave McDonald.
Yeah! Thank you very much.
Yeah, Davey Mac.
Yeah.
Woo!
Yeah.
I'm not asking for a chant of Davey Mac. I'm not asking. Well,
Davey Mac.
I'm not asking. I'm not asking for a chant of East Side Dave.
East Side Dave.
I'm not asking for a chant of David Big Cock. That would be a lie, by the way. It's the Davey Mac Sports Program.
Yeah.
My name is East Side Dave, a.k.a. the Davey Mac, the Dave McDonald. With me, Mr. Sunshine, ladies and gentlemen, Chris Pepper Stanley.
Oh, thanks, Dave. Thank you.
You know, I realize every week you get surprised when I introduce you. You go, whoa! Oh, thanks, Dave.
It's weird. Every week, there's a chance
every
of Eastside Dave.
And we do this show on the old iTunes and the Riotcast and on Sirius XM. And every week you go, oh, thank you.
I just think one day it might end. By my own hand.
You're probably right. Homicide Suicide is upon us very shortly. Engineer extraordinaire, ladies and gentlemen, his name is Shano.
Shano.
With us, as always, the three-time Emmy Award-winning sound engineer, produced such brilliant albums by Deepak Chopra and company. His name is Roy Schaefer.
Roy.
Hey, Dave.
And that's
doing?
No lie. I'm doing good, Ryan.
All right. I'm doing a lot better than Pepper is today, that's for sure.
We have.
What are you talking about?
You've come in a very dark mood, but hold on. We'll get to that shortly.
There's nothing to get to.
And very special guest on guitar. Once a year. You know, we only have two guests that occur annually,
that's
just
right.
Once a year. Mr. Ray Wiley Hubbard, famous, legendary Austin, Texas singer, songwriter, musician. Brilliant guy.
Yep.
And Charno's tax accountant. And his name is Dave Richter, everybody.
Tax accountant and very good friend.
No, I don't think that very good on guitar. That was Dave Richter on guitar, ladies and gentlemen. So he'll be sitting in with a beautiful Fender guitar and a Fender amp.
No, it's a Gibson.
It's a Gibson Fender. I know Jack and whatever. I don't need to know everything. Whatever. It's fine. These go up to 11 is what they said, Spile Tap.
That's right.
But, you know, a thought occurred to me.
What's that, Dave?
It's March 13th, 2013, which means the next Davey Mac Sports program will be March 20th. That'll be after March 17th. What does that mean to you, Pepper?
That is St. Patrick's Day.
St. Patrick's Day!
All right, I got it right. I thought it might be the 15th.
Which means you're Irish, for Christ's sake.
Who cares? Everyone's Irish on St. Patrick's
Day. You know, I was talking to my wife, and she said, is Pepper Irish? I go, look at him. Of course he's Irish.
I'm that black Irish.
That's what I said. Yeah. I go, he's a Baldwin.
I wish.
Chuckles. Followed up that thing. I said, Pep, why are you chuckling? Pepper looks like he could be a part of the Baldwin clan.
Yeah.
In fact, I would get rid of Stephen Baldwin and put Pepper in that place. In terms of success, sure, Pepper was an unusual suspect.
But what else
does
he have?
Yeah, Pepper also didn't make Biosphere. So as far as I'm concerned, Pepper's up on Stephen.
I could do
Although,
a Jesus freak out.
He might be my favorite Celebrity Apprentice superstar of all time. Donald Trump, even in regular Apprentice or Celebrity Apprentice, should always have Stephen Baldwin. He is magnetic on that show. He is so bleeping funny and just, it's like watching Michael Corleone go to work. He was whispering things in Dee Snider this past Sunday, and Dee Snider's like, this was weird. He was whispering things in my ear. It was just very weird.
He just got banged for $350,000 from the IRS.
Seriously?
Yeah, he was going to do time. But instead, he said he'll pay back the money.
You mean the money you owe?
Yeah.
And by the way, he was riding his skateboard in Celebrity Apprentice.
He still has a skateboard?
He still has the skateboard. On the Ron and Fez show, when I was a producer there, one time Stephen Baldwin came in for the, I think it was Christians for Skateboarders.
Yeah, Skateboarding for Jesus.
Or Born Again or Skateboarding for Jesus.
Yeah.
And he literally rode into the studio on a skateboard. I never saw anything like it.
It's the only radical way someone
It was
come in.
So goddamn funny. It was like a 45-year-old Bart Simpson had come into the studio. It was so funny. So I'm like, obviously this is a gimmick.
Yeah.
But then on Celebrity Apprentice this past Sunday, he was riding a skateboard while they were supposed to be painting signs at Universal Orlando.
Has he been voted out yet or no?
No. Listen, Trump knows how good... There are some people who get voted out on merit, and then some people who stay in just because they're good TV. Stephen Baldwin always makes it to, like, final five or six because he's just too much fun.
Doesn't Trump have, like, someone who helps him out, like that old man?
Oh, George? He's been long gone, Pepper Stan.
I haven't seen him in a long time.
Oh, baby, George and the weird blonde-haired woman are long gone.
Why didn't you just bring in Stephen Baldwin? This is new.
No, his little companions are the Trumps now. Ivanka is with substitutes for the blonde-haired woman,
and
then Don Jr. And then this past week, sometimes Eric Trump comes in.
That sounds like nepotism to me.
And this is a weird thing to say,
but I was noticing Piers Morgan or something like that. Isn't he on there?
Well, no. Piers Morgan participated in like the first or second Celebrity Apprentice and won. But all the Trumps have very weird mouths. And yes, I was looking at Eric Trump and Donald Trump Jr.'s mouths.
Hot.
But they're just like, they're kind of.
Well, Donald, I don't know, Dad.
Donald has a weird mouth.
It's a mouth of
And they always do the same thing. Right before, in the 7 minutes to go in the show, and Donald goes to his left and right and he goes, "Well, what do you think I should do?" And they're always like, "It's a tough call." Every single time.
So come down to the wire, Dad.
Yeah. So anyway, the point is this: yes, Pepper is Irish. And you know what? He's one of the most handsome goddamn Irishmen I've ever seen.
Yeah. Oh, thanks, Dave.
And this is the Davey Mac Sports Program annual St. Patrick's Day special.
Yeah! Woo-hoo!
So what we want you to do is listen and have a good time. And then on Sunday, on March 17th, you play it again and you'll have a good time. And the people who, if you're at a party, there'll be certain people who say, "What the hell is this? What is this?"
The best damn thing you're going to listen to is what it is. That's what you tell them.
That's right.
You make them feel like idiots.
That's right. So having said that, we'll say this. If I should fall from grace of God, where no doubt can relieve me, if I'm buried deep inside, angels won't receive me. Let me go, boys. Let me go, boys. Let me go down in the morning. Rivers always drag. David is a funny. Let me go, boys. Let me go, boys. Let me go out in the morning. Rivers over. Woo! Come on. Oh, if I should fall from grace of God, where no doubt can relieve me, if I'm better underneath the sun, when angels will be see me. Let me go, boys. Let me go, boys. Let me go out in the rivers. Rivers over. Let me go, boys. Let me go, boys. Let me go out in the river, river go. One more, let me go, boys. Let me go, boys. Hey, la 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 la. Woo! St. Patrick's Day special right here on the Davey Mac Sports Program. Thank you. Yeah, clap it up, Dave Richter.
Yeah.
Clap it up.
You did it.
Clap it up, fuzzball. I can't believe this guy who's sitting there with a Fender and drinking beers and stuff.
It's
going to, after the show,
still a Gibson.
Whatever it is, is then going to do Charno's taxes. Somehow Charno, his tax return is going to be minus $1,000. Charno's going to be like, hey, what the hell's going on here? You don't invite your tax accountant to get drunk on the Davey Mac Sports Program.
It's a St. Patrick's Day show.
Well, yeah. Pepper's right. You know what? 52 points for Pepper.
Wow.
And by the way, I want to announce this. Actually, let's just do the spot. It's for tweakedaudio.com. Is it, Pepper?
Yeah, tweet. Tweakedaudio.com.
Tweakedaudio.com. And what we have here with Tweaked Audio is the best. The number. Forget about Dr. Dre's new headphones.
You don't even need to know what they are called.
They're stupid.
They're garbage.
Tweaked Audio, they're earbuds. They're made of wood. They're mic'd and non-mic'd models available. They're designed to sound great for music and talk.
Both?
I'm holding them right now in my hand. And I'm going to tell you something, my friends. They look spectacular. They sound even better. I got myself the wood version. Well, I didn't. Tweaked Audio sent three pairs.
Classy.
So if you go to tweakedaudio.com right now, you put in the promo code Davey, D-A-V-E-Y, you're going to get a third off the goddamn
33% off.
The third
it's
off.
A third of them. Come on, treat yourself to some Tweaked Audio.
Is the music really loud, or is that
yes,
just
yes, it is. It's really loud.
I think we need to adjust the music levels. Just to... Thank you, Sean. Jesus Christ.
Is this a live game?
I can't hear myself think over here. These guys... I'm like at a Metallica concert. Hey, Pepper!
Yeah, Dave?
I can't wait till they play Enter Sandman!
What?
Hey, tweakedaudio.com, this was the worst promo spot. Hey, you know
cut
what?
Cut that don't, part out.
Don't pay us this week.
Do pay us.
Actually, cut that part out. So we got three pairs. Roy Schaefer already took the very sleek-looking black pair.
God damn it.
That means there's two pairs left for David, Pepper, and Shawno.
Oh, my God.
And I want the wood pair. Now, what we're going to do with this green pair, which is fantastic, is like Batman Dark Knight, I'm going to put a stick... I'm gonna crack a stick in half.
A pool cue.
And Pepper and Shunno are going to fight each other to the death live on Ustream and Riotcast and iTunes.
Finally. Or we could just do it Django Unchained style.
My money's with Pepper Stanley.
Thanks, Dave.
You know why?
Why is that?
He ain't got nothing to lose. That's why.
There you go. You nailed it.
TweakedAudio.com.
Davey is the code Davey. Get 33% off.
Yeah, I would take Pepper in a fight against almost anyone at this point. I mean, the dark mood that he came in tonight. I'd take Pepper against any UFC fighter. Yeah, you hear that, Brock Lesnar?
Yeah, I'm gonna pull a knife or a
gun. Is he still around?
I think he used to be, but now he's back in WWE. I think.
All right, Ken Shamrock. Because
really
I know
old.
A lot about my UFC stuff.
That was the last time I actually did watch UFC when Ken Shamrock was fighting.
I actually watched a pay-per-view UFC. It was when he went to the WWE. Had a good, decent career in WWE.
Oh, yeah, great.
Then came back to UFC.
That.
And I his first fight or whatever, I actually bought the pay-per-view or watched it, and he got annihilated. And it's like, yeah, you've been... I mean, listen, I respect wrestling and know that when a guy gets body slammed, it hurts.
Yeah, it's choreographed.
Who got clotheslined... And got a leg drop on his head. Dangerous Danny Doring of the ECW showed me
legend.
A thing or two. Yeah, he slapped me around like he was Dr. D. David Schultz slapping around John Stossel in that famous YouTube clip.
Well, you guys had a lot of practice beforehand, right?
No, I tried to practice in the gym, and he couldn't get access to the gym. And instead, we had to practice for a very big wrestling match at the Hard Rock Cafe. He made his practice in a bank parking lot in goddamn February or March, 32 degrees, and there was ice on the pavement.
Whoa, not professional.
No, it wasn't. And then he blames me. He's like, yeah, man, I call Dave all the time, and he never wanted... That has never happened, coke nose.
Why would you
who knows?
Come on.
Danny Doring? That's all I have to say about him. But it is our St. Patrick's Day special, so we're not pointing fingers at anybody.
Never.
Pepper, March 17th, this Sunday, what are you going to do for St. Patrick's Day? Any special plans?
Drink till you black out.
But I mean,
doesn't matter
out?
Where or
do you go
how
out?
It happens.
Do you go to a friend's house?
I prefer house parties since the bars are just...
Yeah, I agree. Right?
But then
I
also,
agree with that.
I have friends who own bars, so I always go there.
It's good to like... I think it's good to do like in a noon or 1 o'clock p.m. bar thing, but then you want to go back to a house, you know. Yeah. Once it gets to 5 o'clock,
everyone's
and
gone.
It's always a drunk chick. Woo! Oh, this is gonna be hot. I want 7 Irish car bombs.
Miss, you're black.
7.
You puked 2 minutes.
Well, I have 6 friends.
There
and
you
I'm
go.
Gonna get. I'm gonna take my tits out.
They're already out.
Oh, yeah, that's right. But I got some green tassels on.
Oh, yeah.
St. Patrick's Day is my favorite day of the year, though, to go out in public because people are always like, look at the red-haired boy. Oh, it's like I'm Santa Claus, you know, with the red hair. Everyone's like, oh, my God. When I went to St. Patrick's Day, I actually marched in a St. Patrick's Day Boston parade in 2004, and I overheard 2 kids go, yeah, look at it. That guy's from Southie, pointing at me.
Well, the red hair thing.
I'm like, I'm from South Jersey, dog. Is that what you mean by Southie? I got your apples.
Yeah,
the Goodwill Hunting thing was.
Yeah.
Anyway, let's talk some sports real quick.
Thank you, guys.
What the? Roy, come on.
I've been waiting for this.
You quiet down. All right, Pepper's in a bad enough mood.
I'm not in a bad mood.
You need a little tickle?
We were out there on the fire escape smoking before the show. It was a dark place.
Tickle.
Wasn't it? Or no?
No. Give him a little tickle.
The fact
Dave.
That you whispered
yeah.
no. means it was a dark
Come on,
place.
Dave. Give him a little tickle.
I know when Pepper's lying, he whispers.
Tickle him, Dave.
You know?
Yeah, I think a little tickle.
Pepper.
Tickle time.
Did you do a little Adderall
tickle
no.
time,
last
Dave.
Night?
No.
God damn, I did. Pepper, did you do a little Coke?
No.
That's how you know. He was lying. The first one, he's very boisterous. I'm not tickling Pepper.
Come on, tickle him.
No. You tickle.
Bit.
Dave. You can tickle Pepper.
No.
Pepper.
I wouldn't do it.
Yeah, Dave's not going to go there.
I told you about my space issue.
Hold on. Give him the microphone for a second.
Yeah, I told you about my space issue.
Oh, but before the show, Dave Richter. And by the way, another round of applause for Dave Richter, who's sitting in tonight playing the Fender 360 guitar.
Thank you.
And whatever. And
Xbox he's playing.
Guitar Hero.
That's Pepper's tax man. And before the show... Dave Richter and Roy Schaefer came in and tried to give each other a bro hug, but there was a chair in between them.
Oh my God.
So they had to lean over like this. And it was like they, like, and for the people at home who are just listening, it was like they leaned over. How would you
a chair.
Describe
a
that?
A
no, I mean,
they're bent over.
They were bent over like they were both going to take a pretzel rod in the ass. Okay.
And so they're just their shoulders were touching.
Yeah, it was very, very weird. I'm not going to lie. I was really uncomfortable with the whole, and I actually pointed out.
No
I,
homo.
I, you know, a classier individual, because it happened right behind me. So a classier individual would just, you know, ignore it. And I'm like, well, that was weird, wasn't it?
I'm going to point that out.
No
Mike Frantz. So the Pope happened today.
Yeah, it was big. Argentina.
I got a tweet, or I put out a tweet that got, as of now, 21 retweets, where I said that, I'm hoping the new pope is the old pope with a silly disguise mustache. Thank you.
Thank you, Roy.
Thank you, Dave. And anyway, but the greatest thing was sports talk legend Mike Francesa from 660 AM. He was doing some pope coverage. And, well, everything that we've said about Mike Francesa may be true. I just think he's getting old. He's getting a little long
dementia,
in the tooth.
A little dementia.
There's dementia. If you hear dead spots in the audio, it's don't worry. Nothing's buffering. Mike takes a long time.
So this is all
this
nothing
is
altered. This is
nothing
live radio.
Altered. And it's a minute 45. We'll try and get through most of it. But Sean, I'll be prepared to pause because I'm going to have to comment
all right,
at certain times.
Ready?
Thank you, Sean.
See anything printed on the screen. I don't have the sound on, folks. I can't tell you what it says. Oh, these guys couldn't understand what he was saying inside, so they didn't put up a graphic yet, so we don't have a graphic.
Here we go.
The cardinal from...
Dead spot.
This is it? The archbishop... Well, he's an archbishop, though.
Oh, well, pause. I'm sorry. I tried to get through. I couldn't. Again, one of the most confusing things is that Mike Francesa doesn't, for whatever reason, allow his producers to talk on the air. Now, can you imagine if Ron and Fez or whatever, Howard Stern or Imus didn't allow his producers to talk on the air? So it's a one-sided conversation.
Yeah, they're just doing the talkback, right?
Where, yeah, the talkback button, which, of course, in the radio thing, is that they are talking into Mike's headphones. He's right. Answering them, but their voices aren't on the air. So we're hearing the craziest one-sided conversation you'll ever hear in your life. I for some bizarre reason, he has blacklisted his own producers.
That's really bizarre.
Why does that happen?
He's afraid that they'll take his job.
Something happened once that...
Honestly,
maybe
Pepper, I don't think so. But I don't know. Well, you know what? He did have a producer called Carlin, who, by the way, he was a big guy. Yeah. And this is how nice Mike was. They called him the Continent.
Oh, my
because
God.
Because he was very fat.
Yeesh. Must have been.
Ouch. Kettle.
Bam! You hear that, Mike? Pepper's on your ass. He's on your ass, Mikey.
In a gay way.
Yeah. He's going to nail it from behind.
Sure.
Now listen. All right. Let's keep going. So here's Francesa. And he's still talking about the Pope.
This is the Pope. From Buenos Aires. From Argentina. He's it. Is that it? So Cardinal Jorge Mario Bergoglio. He's the new Pope. The Cardinal from Argentina. Okay, so the cardinal from Argentina, 76-year-old pope. So they went for an older pope. Okay, so cardinal.
Here we go.
Cardinal.
He's really struggling with this name here.
You guys will tell me when they say it inside how you say his name, and then we'll find out what his papal name. But basically, the cardinal from Argentina. There might be two. I don't even know if there are two from Argentina.
Two the popes!
Cardinal from Argentina.
We got the first ever
cardinal from Argentina. Duo is
pope.
The new pope. So,
dead air.
I don't know how you say his name to be exact. you know. So that is it. The Argentinian cardinal is the new pope. He is 76 years old. So,
please, Roy.
Let's see if I get a little bio on him as to what kind of pope we're talking about. as far as, you know,
like he's talking like about Robinson Cano's career numbers.
Let me see if he was.
Yeah, seven exorcisms.
The best thing about, the best thing about sports guys is they cannot change their delivery.
So, you know, in 2008.
What's his stats?
He had an average of 4.8 miracles. And, anyway, what's the Pope's name? Jorge Pajama Bama.
Bergoglio.
Is that a name?
No.
Okay.
You're making things up.
His name was Felipe Bananarama.
Wrong.
And I think he did the song, I'm your Venus, I'm your fire, I'm your soul desire. I can't exactly remember what. Here's the point.
Yeah.
The new Pope is 76 years old.
He's old.
And I don't want to. You know, I don't pronounce Hispanics' names well.
Yeah, obviously. No,
you know, the racial epithet for that?
I don't. Yes?
Spick!
Yeah, all right. Why would you say that, Mike, on the air?
The point is this.
You're a racist?
Chiche Lavagne Hisparado Antonio Pope Antonio Banderas IV has come out. And we've got white smoke, and that means that Davey Mac is smoking up in his garage. Now, here's the point I have to say. Thank God the Mexican from Argentina...
He's just an Argentinian.
...was just voted in as Pope. That's right. Jorge Villachez IV.
Wrong.
Our first papal midget who later would commit suicide. That's a factoid that most people don't know. He, Hervé Villachez, the third Pepe, is not in retirement.
Really?
He killed himself.
That's sad.
His, now, the Pope last year hit 294 for the Columbus Clippers in the Yankee minor league system.
Wait. The guy that was voted in the Popehood used to play ball.
That's right. Oh, I'm sorry. I was thinking of Jesus Montero.
All right.
Sorry about that, Pepe.
You're racist. This is racist.
Pepe.
Yeah.
I can't tell one Hispanic for the next.
You shouldn't be saying this out loud.
I thought early 90s Yankee shortstop Alvaro Espinosa was just voted in Pope. And somewhere there's two Yankee fans chuckling.
I'm not even sure if that's happening.
Dave Richter's one of them.
Dave Richter's a Yankee fan. Thank God you're here. You remember SB?
Yeah.
Before ESPN had the ESPYs, the Yankees had SB. Alvaro Espinosa, who Phil Rizzuto one time called future Hall of Famer.
And that's a true f***ing serious.
Mark it.
That's a true story. I remember watching a Yanks game in like 92, and Phil Rizzuto was like, holy cow. I'm telling you right now, Alvaro Espinosa's going to Cooperstown.
You're like, Philly, it's 225. The hell is he going to the Cooperstown? I know he's got a good glove, but, you know, Ozzie Smith at least hit 289 or 290 career.
Let's see if I'm right. I'm going to say Ozzie Smith hit 290, but I'm going to say Ozzie Smith hit 289 career. I almost want to say 284.
So what is it? What is it? Tell me.
Pick one.
I'll say 284. Pepper. Roy's looking it up right now. And Roy, what's the answer? What'd sports computer say?
It's still making the noise.
Yes.
Okay.
No, it's not.
What does the sports computer say?
260.
Oh my God!
Way off.
How the hell is he in the Hall of Fame? I know he's got a good goal. And by the way,
backflips.
What is that? No, you're actually right about that.
And what, sweet
and what does that mean? If Ozzie Smith makes the Hall of Fame with 262, that means Omar Vizquel has to. He's every bit as brilliant as a glove guy as Ozzie Smith. Doesn't get the credit because you're right. Didn't do backflips.
Flashy.
Didn't do Omar Vizquel with the glove was as flashy as Ozzie. I guarantee you Omar Vizquel hit 280.
272.
All right, but that's closer. 10 points. Closer. That's 10 points higher.
Closer.
Well,
God.
It's our St. Patrick's Day special, and we have so many wonderful songs prepared for you today. But Oh Danny Boy is one of our favorites. And we're going to sing this, and Pepper's even going to take a turn singing live on the air. You know, you don't even have to worry about the video snippets this week, Peppy.
Hello.
So I want to send this out to everyone who is listening, subscribing to the Davey Mac Sports Program. Subscribe on iTunes and Riotcast.com. That's our neighbors. Or neighbors or our employers, technically. Riotcast.com. Roy, I would like you to sing this with me.
You got it, Dave. I'm always here for you. Here we go.
Oh, Danny boy, the pipes are calling. From glen to glen, around the ocean side. And I will say, the arms on ice are taken. And Pepper Stanley with the tuna can cock. And when I fall, it will end in tomorrow. I'm gone awake and eat it all. Oh, Chris Pepper.
Round of applause.
Yeah.
Round of applause, please.
Yeah.
Roy, round of, thank you.
Yeah. You know, if people would just listen to certain parts of this show, they think we're in a gay relationship.
That brings me to my this brings me to my next segment. Our next segment. Last week I threatened to kick out the Davey Mac Q&A segment forever. And I'm still thinking about it, but I will give it a 1 week respite. And we will be doing the Davey Mac Q&A segment right now!
You've got the Q, and we've got the A. It's the Davey Mac Q&A.
All right, St. Patrick's Day special. I love it. Says, Dear Dave, so because I threatened it, yeah. This one comes from Roy Schaefer. It says, Dear Dave, I would appreciate if you continue the Q&A segment on the show. Without, I don't have a job. I am just a useless 40-year-old sitting at a keyboard.
Ouch.
Sing that jingle gives me meaning to my life. I would give up every Grammy Award I've ever received just to play that jingle. I'm begging you, keep the Q&A segment.
Oh, okay.
Wow. Was that from you?
That was not from me, but I'll take it.
No, I'm starting not to believe it.
It seemed heartfelt.
I'm starting not to believe like that you're
right. It
would
seem like something I would write, right?
So we're going to keep it for this week, but we may suspend. We can't do it every single
give
week.
Give it a rest. Let people, so, you know.
And I have to say this out loud because literally I got inundated with a zillion. I mean, I'm not even joking. You can contact me from the eastsidedavecountry.com. Contact page. And literally, I got, I would say, honestly, 50 to 60 emails that go right into my Gmail account that says, please don't get rid of the Q&A segment.
Q&A's fun. It all started out fun.
But, I mean, this is like our fourth week in a row. You know, I mean, you know, you have to put things on the shelf so they say special. Here's one from LeBron James. It says, I, along with the entire Miami Heat organization, order you to continue the Q&A segment. P.S., does Pepper like to eat ass?
What do you think of that, Pepper, eh?
Sure, LeBron.
The next one on the Davey Mac Q&A.
You've got the Q and we've got the A. It's the Davey Mac Q&A.
We're just really keeping it together.
Here's an example of someone who is very angry at me. Mm-hmm. He says, so Eastside Dave is too good to bring up Pepper's sexuality on Q&A, huh?
What?
Pussy. It's calling me a pussy. We got the Q&A. You got the asshole.
This is mean.
Go ahead, next one.
You've got the Q and we've got the A. It's the Davey Mac Q&A.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know. The guy destroyed me. This one is from Steve. It says, you guys should do a new podcast called Pepper's Tuna Can Cock Talk.
Oh, my God. Oh. I didn't know it was so popular with the Q&A people.
Next one. I'm not even going to address that. Go ahead, Roy.
You've got the Q and we've got the A.
Says, Dear Dave. This is from Carter. Says, Dear Dave, you can't stop the Davey Mac Q&A. It's one of the best parts of the show. I have a question for you. Would you rather take Pepper's tuna can cock up your ass and have him jizz in your eye or take a bath in Francesa's bathwater that he took a crap in?
Well,
why we're putting it on suspension.
Which is it?
Yeah, it's a good question.
I think I know.
I'll take Pepper's cock.
All right.
Roy, next one.
We got the Q and we've got the A. It's the Davey Mac, the old Q and the A.
Ben Roethlisberger from Pittsburgh. By the way, he added the from Pittsburgh as if I would know who Ben Roethlisberger is.
You know, the quarterback.
Make sure it's authentic.
You know, Steelers. Ben Roethlisberger says, why are you taking away Big Q&A? Big Ben's going to rape you if you do. So there you go.
I don't think that was really Big Ben.
Next one, Roy. Roy Shea.
We've got the Q and we've got the A.
And our final one, Dear Dave, this is from Ron, says, Dear Dave, you can't end the Q&A segment. By the way, does Pepper wear butt plugs when he goes to bed? If so, can he wear one during the next show? Next
no
week.
No and no. Hmm. I'll answer that.
How much money, though? $35,000 just to wear a butt plug? No one's going to see it. You're not going to be wearing it on
35
TV.
35 grand tax-free, sure.
Yeah, I'll do it, too.
Roy Schaefer, bring in one of your butt plugs!
Bring in the $35,000.
Bring in the $35,000.
plug Q&A.
We've got the Q, they've got the A. Hey, hey Mac, Q&A. St. Patty's Day, Q&A.
Well, we go to the hat, we go to the fence, we go to the place, and we go to the place, we go to the place, we go to the hay, we go to the place, and we go. We drink the beer, we hit the guy, we hit the punch, we punch the day. You can go to the Q&A. Go to the fence and go and eat the barley water. What state of grace? It's the Q&A. Miller's Crossing and Brothers McMullen and Irish Movie, it's the Q&A. Red hair and your mommy's big tits and your jerk off too, it's Q&A.
Glorious.
It's a St. Patrick's Day special here on the Davey Mac Sports Program.
He would be proud.
As you can probably tell, is what I'm thinking. Peppy.
Yeah, Dave.
What do you have for us today?
A lot of NFL free agency stuff. The Dolphins get...
Bring in hamburger.
Pittsburgh's Mike Wallace.
Bring it.
For $60 million, $30 million guaranteed for Mike Wallace.
Whoa. He's okay.
Yeah, he's a good slot
receiver. He's a good receiver.
He's a good slot receiver, but they don't have a quarterback to get it to him.
Yeah, I hate it. What's the guy from Miami's name? It's like it's one of those. He sounds very, very white.
Tannehill?
But yes, you're right. But I will say this. The Dolphins were featured on Hard Knocks last year, and he was the biggest star because his wife is
a very
super, you know, yeah, like super blonde, you know, chick. And
like a generic quarterback wife. Yeah.
And from what some of my inside sources tell me that every single time Tannehill got sacked in the NFL, big, huge black men were just talking about his wife to him. And that's
oh my God.
I swear to God, that's the truth. I have two sources.
Right,
I'm not going to say. I'm not going to say who.
Write it down.
Jim Nance and Phil Simms, dog.
You know those guys?
What kind of things are these guys saying to his wife? I'll
try and think.
Every NFL team watches Hard Knocks. The Hard Knocks on HBO it's not just one of the best, it's probably the best sports reality shows, but it's one of the best reality shows because, let's face it, HBO is the gold standard for sports. It's phenomenal. And so Hard Knocks is so well produced. And to think that they will do a week, and it's the same thing with 24/7. They'll do a week, and I don't even know how they do it. They edit it, you know, on the Tuesday,
yeah,
you know, and then it's put out on Wednesday, and you're like, how is this thing so well produced, music, visuals, and everything? Because they're doing it live during training camp. It's not like they film the show, and then 3 months later, we see the training camp.
Right.
During training camp, we see these episodes in the same way that on 24/7, the boxing show, it's during the boxers' training camp. It's absolutely insane how HBO does. And I'll give credit to another thing on HBO. The Derek Jeter documentary recently came out.
It was last summer, right?
It was last. It was 2011, but they showed it again recently. And I found it to be bittersweet, if not downright sad, at the end when Derek Jeter said that he usually doesn't like any type of documentaries. He's never signed off on one. MLB Network, a whole bunch.
Incredibly private.
ESPN has gone to Derek Jeter and said, can we do a documentary about you? He said no across the board. But HBO, like I said, gold standard, asked him. But he didn't even give HBO as a reason why he did it. He said, I'm now 38 and I have no children and I get jealous when I'm at an all-star game and these guys are bringing their kids onto the field.
Aww.
So I want my kids to see something of when I was a ball player.
Wow.
I'm telling you, all my heroes are going into Sadville. Jordan, Derek Jeter. Like, Jeter sounded legitimately, it was a legitimate depressing statement.
That is a depressing statement, but Jordan's been weird for a long time. Jeter, that's something new. That's really...
Yeah, I found that to be very, very weird. And at the end, they have a little credits and whatnot, and Jordan was actually on the credits and said to Derek Jeter, I think of you like a younger brother. That's got to be... If I could have one dinner with sports people, it would be me, Derek Jeter, and Michael Jordan. I mean, can't get better than that.
No Barkley?
Or the other one would be Charles Barkley and John Kruk, okay?
That'd be awesome. You wouldn't have fun with them?
I would, Pepper, but we've talked about this before. Pepper sees like a great sports dinner as a way to drink and have fun.
Yeah, me too.
If we called up Charles Barkley right now, he'd probably come into the Davey Mac Sports Program.
Then let's do it.
Well, goddamn it, Dave Richter, you're a goddamn multimillionaire. Get Charles Barkley on the phone.
Make the call.
Charles.
Well, he's not this listening.
A mic, not a phone.
Yeah, what are you doing?
Nationally broadcasted radio.
You're goddamn right it is.
Yeah.
Woo! So I'm starting to feel a little bit depressed. Yeah, and Jordan's thing is all weird. You know, Sports Illustrated and ESPN, the magazine.
And just
both
his actions in the news.
Yeah.
What he does.
Here's our man. What's our guy's name again?
My Giuseppe.
Giuseppe.
Giuseppe's here. Come on, Giuseppe. Say hi to people at home. Giuseppe?
Yeah.
I've got one thing for you. Yesterday in the World Baseball Classic, the team USA destroyed Team Puerto Rico 7-1. Comments?
I think they deserve that, man.
Yeah! Woo! One last comment. One last comment. The new Pope?
Oh, forget it, man. I don't want to talk.
Whoa!
Damn!
That is a surprising FU from Giuseppe. As he takes out the, as he empties the trash basket, but he's one of the nicest guys that we know, isn't he? Isn't he fantastic?
The best.
He is
so
the best.
Giuseppe says "F you" to the Pope, and he wears a little crucifix.
I don't think that's what he said.
And he says, "Burn in hell."
New Pope and Hitler are the same person,
right? He says, "Burn in hell, Pope Speedy Gonzalez," which I don't care for because it's racist, and also to call another man a cartoon mouse. It's just like, come on, bro.
Brode.
Yeah, I was smoking up so hard today at 11 o'clock in the morning waiting for this Pope thing. That's my little ritual. Every time there's a new Pope, I smoke up in the garage. I play a little Paul Simon. And I just get, you know, I just chills out, bro.
Well, a lot of people were tweeting, white smoke 420, hashtag Pope, which is just retarded.
When did they do that?
Later in the day, I was saying.
Then they ripped me off because at 11 o'clock or 10:30 in the morning, go to my Twitter, Pepper, twitter.com/EastsideDave. And I think it's the third to last, or you got to go home and tweet.
Yeah, yes, yeah, I know.
I forget. Pepper knows how to do all this stuff. Well, you got to go to tweets. You got to go up. Yeah, the tweets. No, to left. Anyway, where it says tweets.
It's a great show.
Because otherwise. Anyway. It's our same. Okay, here we go. Pepper's on it. Go down. Because I tweeted, hey. Right here.
Hey, Papal Conclave. Here's your white smoke, dog.
And then I put an Instagram of me in the smoke zone. Tooting up a little bit.
Oh, God.
And by the way, if anyone's wondering, if they want to see the Instagram thing, you go to twitter.com/EastsideDave. I am so close to 25,000 followers. I mean, please, people.
Are you smoking a joint there?
And I ain't saying live on this air, but I'll tell you something. I had myself a great Papa Conclave, bro. Much better than Mike Francesa's. If people are noticing, from left to right, that's a Guns N' Roses poster. To the right of that is a Pink Floyd and The Who 1967 poster. To the right of that, Empire Strikes Back. Thank you very much.
Wow.
Why are you applauding yourself for the posters?
Yeah, it's like a 14-year-old boy's room.
You shut up! Well, it's the Davey Mac Sports Program, St. Paddy's Day special, and we have a song for everyone. And this is by the famous musician who's from Ireland, Elvis Costello, I believe. Go ahead, Roy. All right. If I walk down, come on, Roy. Yes. Trouble snow. Searching for life in the darkness of sanity.
Oh, yeah.
I ask myself, do it's all hope gone? And is it alive in misery? Just things you wanna try. What's so funny about peace, love, and understanding? Oh, what's so funny about peace, love, and understanding?
Thursday special. We got Roy Schaefer on keyboards and Dave Richter on guitar. Oh, and Sean on drum and Chris Pepper Stanley. And we got the tuna can cock. Oh, tuna can cock. And it's time I feel it slipping away. Just made me wanna try. What's so funny about that beast loving us?
Last part again, those last two chords. Listen to it. Wait, hold on. Listen to this. Yeah, go again. I've never heard, I thought about this before, but that sounds like something. No, just play the chords the way you had it.
Bam, bam, bam.
You know what I'm thinking?
Teenage Wasteland. It's on a teenage wasteland.
Dave Richter, everybody, on guitar. Here we go. Yeah! All right! Roy jumped in for the bagpipes after the song was over. I like that. I like that part. You know, I never thought about that before. And you know what? Us musical geniuses, Roy and I looked at each other. One of them was wearing huge sunglasses. So I can't tell. Sometimes I can't tell if Roy and I are actually making eye contact or if he's still looking at Giuseppe.
Well.
And, you know, making sure that the guy doesn't steal anything. Hey, come on! He's Hispanic. He's not a thief. A goddamn new pope is Hispanic, for Christ's sake. I ain't going to tolerate your BS anymore, Shake.
Does he make his own liquor, too?
He does, yeah. He uses his own.
He bottles up his own tequila.
No, he's releasing his own line of liquor.
He makes his own liquor in the bathtub. Hey, what do you know?
Tastes like.
Michael Vick had to cancel his book tour
because
he was getting death threats.
That's
from
ridiculous.
People. I mean, let it go already.
He did his time. He did hard time.
Let it go. I mean, all he did was. Roy, all he did was electrocute dogs, for crying out loud. You know, drown dogs. I mean, take some Christmas lights and strangle dogs until their eyeballs popped out.
You put them on their misery.
Put his big black dick in some dog's ass. He stabbed, took a big f***ing instrument and stabbed a dog in the dick hole with
it. A knife?
I think I'm about to mark that one, Chono.
Hogtied some dog and let Davey Mac put his dick in the dog's mouth.
Would you want to put your dick in the dog's mouth?
I have and I will again. Well, it's a St. Patrick's Day special, and you know,
it still is.
I am so happy to be here with my friends, Roy Schaefer, Sean O, Pepper, and my best friend, Dave Richter, who is just one of the most wonderful people in the world.
Beautiful brown-eyed man.
And
he's got those beautiful brown eyes.
Are you trying to segue a song?
He's leading it in. Yeah, come on. I want to get this one in before it's too late.
All right, let's get this one in. But we just did a song. All right, let's do a quick version. You don't have to, Pepper. No more. No more video snippets.
What key?
Here's another Irish person song. It's got nothing to do with Ireland, and I was hesitant to even do this.
All right.
But Pepper is definitely, since you're not taking a video snippet, you're definitely going to sing part of this song.
Seriously.
Sure.
Okay, here we go.
2, 3, go.
And here we go. Down the thin air. Down the hollow.
Who did guess?
I didn't.
In a mist anymore.
Pepper did the worst guess. It really smells terrible. What are you doing?
It just came out.
You just ruined Brown Eyed Girl.
Brown Eyed.
All right,
stop it.
Stop it. Stop.
Why did you stop?
I have to say to everyone,
be a professional.
No, be a professional.
That was
Pepper's Brown Eyed Girl.
People at home.
Oh my God!
Who are either watching or listening on iTunes?
What?
This is the worst. This is Apocalypse Now nonsense. This is honestly, Roy, open the goddamn window.
It's not that bad.
Oh my God, it's terrible.
Be a professional.
Dude, that's bad.
Work through
it. I am. No, I can't.
That's not being a
professional.
That's
like someone getting their arm cut off and saying work through it. You know, unless this is Monty Python, the Holy Grail, no one's going to be able to work through it.
Tie up
a just a flesh wound.
Did you bleed on me?
Oh my God, this is so bad.
Oh, stop.
No, it really is,
You're
Pepper.
A baby.
Holy mackerel.
We had Brown Eyed Girl all ready to go. Yeah. Everyone was all happy.
I kind of like it.
You're not. I'm happy still.
Nah. I think it smells good, Pat.
Nah, you killed it for me. I can never listen to that song again.
Honestly, I wanted to talk about the Miami Heat winning their 19th straight game, and I was just thinking about the Miami farts. Bam, Roy, give me a question for Pepper and Pepper only, because the rest you are just three
unconscious.
Goddamn screw jobs. No offense, Dave Richter. The Heat have won 19 straight games. The record is the 1971-72 Los Angeles Lakers, or maybe it was 70-71. I know it took place in 71. They won 33 games. Will the Heat tie or break that record?
Neither. That some they're going to lose.
They're going to fall short.
They're going to fall short, yeah.
You just heard it from Chris Pepper Stanley. F you, LeBron. F you hard.
Let me see the rest of their schedule. I'll tell you where they lose.
Well, I know that when they're around 25 or 26, they're going to be playing the San Antonio Spurs.
There you go.
But Tony Parker's not playing. And Tony Parker's a hell of a basketball player.
He's out for a couple more weeks, right?
Yeah. Yeah. I have done a total 180 with LeBron. I am actually thinking of going down. You know, we do the show in Times Square and buying LeBron James paraphernalia.
Oh,
maybe
God.
A tank top. And maybe I will just say no more Knicks and Nets.
I understand that you like the way he plays, but that's a bit far, Dave.
He is playing a brand of basketball that is about the most fun thing I've ever seen since the heyday of Michael Jordan. But it's even different than Jordan because he's so big. That he's getting rebounds, he's blocking shots.
It's ridiculous.
I mean, it's insane.
It's kind of scary.
I love him. I love him to death. I'd like to suck his black ass.
That's creepy. That's weird.
Right, Dave? Dave Richter, everybody.
Absolutely.
Dave Richter, you should be here every single week.
Why?
You should be doing Show Notes taxes every week.
I need to get some taxes done, too.
Why don't you learn a musical instrument? Everyone knows I am, I would say, third greatest singer in rock and roll history behind
what?
Mick and Axel.
Who would say that?
Drunk people.
How drunk are they?
What? Very. Why don't you have a musical talent?
I don't know. I never really got into learning much as a child.
How about maracas for the next Davey Mac Sports program?
That'd be great.
Pepper shaking him and whatnot.
Yeah.
I'll be like, who is it? Who is the guy in Danny Warhol's? Not Danny Warhol's. Yeah.
Joel.
Joel. Yeah, Joel. Yeah.
The tambourine
Brian
guy?
Yeah,
tambourine. Tambourine. I love that guy with the big mutton chops.
I would grow mutton chops, have a tambourine, just fight with Dave the entire show.
He meant absolutely nothing to that band.
I think he was the one who talked business for them.
Yeah, he was the energy. He was the energy.
No,
he wasn't the energy. He was
no,
just
wasn't.
A weird hanger-on that just fell into it.
I saw Brian, and if people don't know, we're talking about Brian Jonestown Massacre, the band. And if you haven't seen the documentary, Dig, It's one of the best documentaries. It's because how many documentaries go last over the span of 7 years that movie was? So in the beginning of Brian Jonestown Massacre, he's talking to the filmmakers. He's like, "Hi, how are you, everybody?" You know, and by like the end of year seven, he's like, "Get these cameras away from me!"
He's total psycho,
you know, and he's totally down.
Actually, it's on YouTube. The whole thing's on YouTube.
Oh my
for God! Free.
It's honestly, even if you, and I actually am a Brian Jonestown Massacre. I hate the Dandy Warhols, but I love Brian Jonestown Massacre, specifically three albums. Give It Back,
Satanic.
No, Thank You for the Mental Illness, and there's another one. Give It Back and Bring It Home. Or I don't know. There's three that are really, really good. If anyone likes them, but I saw a Brian Jonestown Massacre one time, and it was a weird scene because people were yelling at him to like
be
crazy and stuff. And he was trying to ignore them, and finally he's like, "F you, bro! F you! I'm out of here!"
That sucks.
And so he leaves the stage, and it takes 45 minutes, and he finally came back because it was New York City, and it was a sold-out, I think it was Roseland, it was sold out.
That's nice.
But, I mean, you know, I thought the people were dicks.
No, they totally were.
Act crazy, man!
Yeah, okay. I want to see him perform. The music's actually good.
That's right. It's all about the music, dudes.
What?
Speaking of music, we've got one last... St. Patrick's Day song. That's for everybody. We want to thank you all for subscribing on riotcast.com and iTunes. This is it.
I'm not.
Happy St. Patrick's Day, everybody. Subscribe to the show. I want to thank Chris Pepper Stanley.
Thank you, Dave.
I want to thank Roy Schaefer. I want to thank Sean O. I want to thank special guest Guitar Genius.
Yeah, absolutely.
Dave Richter. And I want to thank myself, Eastside Dave.
Yeah, Davey Mac.
Subscribe to the show on iTunes. I'll see you on Saturday, Sirius XM.
7 p.m.
Good night.